Hey everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is my very first video where I am giving my voice as requested by few of my friends, so thought of starting with some colorful lighting. As promised to my vegetarian friends, I am cooking a vegetarian dish, the fourth and the last in the vegetarian series. So welcome to my YouTube channel Arora the Vilayati Khana, and today we are making red kidney bean burger, bole to rajma ki tikki ka burger. For making burger patty, we will have 2 cups of boiled rajma. Mark your rabbit. Oh yeah, hygiene is important. So let me sanitize my hands before I touch the kidney beans or the rajma. So now my hands are completely sanitized. So we would mash these rajma properly to make these sticky sauce. Unfortunately, I couldn't found a masher at my place, so bought a new one. So whenever I required for my next video, will use that one across. Mash the rajmas when they are little warm or on hotter side, because it will become far more easier for you to mash them. Once it becomes cold, it becomes little harder to mash it. So my advice is to mash it when it is warm. As you can see, the rajma or beans has been mashed properly. We will add a boiled potato to our mashed mixture. So potato will actually give you a good binding and all. And please do not forget to subscribe my channel if you haven't done it already. So we will mix the potato as well as the mashed beans together. Mix both of them properly. You can also follow me on Instagram at Arora the Vilayati Khana, and goes by the same name on the Facebook. We will add 2 tablespoons of oil. It could be any oil that you can use. And we will add a seasoning, which is salt, dry mango, black pepper and red chilies. Seasoning will give the burger patty a good spiciness. That tanginess will come from the dry mango that we are using, from the black pepper and all. So mix the seasoning well into the mixture. Texture of your mixture should be not that hard, not that soft. It should be well blended. So we will add chili flakes and oregano as per your requirement, as per the taste. And we will also add mint leaves. The mint leaves will give an added freshness to your burger patty. So I would keep giving you some hacks which will make cooking easy in all my videos. So you can see that the mixture has been perfectly mashed for the burger patty. To make the patty, we will grease our palms with some oil so that the mixture doesn't stick to your hand. So we will make a good round shaped patties across. So we can just with the hand, by pressing it on the top, on the side, we can give it a round shape. And once the patty is ready, we will give it a quick dip into the corn flour. So the corn flour will further add to the boundingness of the patty. So it's when you're doing a shallow fry or warming onto your pan, it will not explode. So we will keep our burger patties on a side. Next, we will be making caramelized onion. So have you bought this portable gas stove till now or not? You can buy it on Amazon. The link has been given in my description. So let's heat a pan and add a tablespoon of butter for caramelizing the onions. We will grease the pan properly. Please, another reminder to you to subscribe my channel if you haven't done so. We will add a tablespoon of oil. So we are adding the oil so it doesn't let butter burn. Otherwise, sometimes your butter will burn quickly and it will leave a burnt taste into your mouth. So add a tablespoon of oil to your butter. Add your sliced onions to the pan and give it a good mixture. We will fry it on a high heat until it turns a little translucent. So this video will become little more faster, as it take 15 to 20 minutes to caramelize the onion. So we will just give it a good stir till your onion becomes translucent. We will add little bit of water to stop that overheatingness of the onion and let it get caramelized on a slow heat, very slow heat. For the trick is to caramelize onion that it has to be on a slow heat, otherwise your onion will burn. You can add salt to the onions. It will help onions to caramelize little faster. you have to cook the onions on very low heat, covered, and you have to give it a stir in between. You can add a little bit of more water so that the heat doesn't get captured into the onions. If the onions get burned, it will not give you a good taste. Caramelized onion will add that sweetness, nuttiness to your burger, which is really important, trust me. So you can see how I'm caramelizing the onion. It's become little golden in color now. So just add, like I said, I have added the salt later on. You can add initially and give it a good mix, and see, now it has become golden brown translucent color. Your caramelized onion is ready. We will transfer it and keep it aside for the dressing part. Please do not forget to follow me on Arvada Vilayati Khana on Instagram and Facebook, and I would request you share with your friends and support me. So the next step, we will cook our burger patties. We will add oil on a preheated pan. We will grease the oil, we will spread the oil to the each corners of the pan and let it heat for couple of minutes before putting our burger patty onto the pan. We will cook it on a medium high heat, so we will cook each side for 3 to 4 minutes till it turns a little brown. So I'm just spreading the oil so that the patties are cooked properly and nicely. You can see our side is, one side is cooked. We will just flip it over to cook the other side of the patty. We will cook it for another 3 to 4 minutes, the other side on a medium to high heat. You can see how nicely the one side has been cooked. You can see the brownishness, the crispiness that is there onto the top of the patty. You can press it a little bit to transfer the heat across to the inside of the patty also. So now your patties are cooked. We would move on to the next part of assembling the burger. So we have taken a burger bun. I'm just splitting it half or cutting it half from the between. Next, we will toast our burger buns on the preheated pan, so you can keep the soft side inside, and you can just on a very high heat you can toast your burger buns. You can even toast it in a toaster if you have, or into a microwave oven. It has to be on a convection if you're using the microwave oven, or into your OTG oven. Now comes the assembly part. So we will add the lettuce leaves to the burger. We would add couple of slices of tomatoes, your patty, and on the top of the patty goes your cheese slice. Now in a preheated pan on a high heat, we'll add a burger, cover it with a lid so that the cheese melts a little bit and gets dripped into the patty and onto the burger. You can do this thing into your microwave oven. It has become little soft. If you are softening your cheese in a microwave, try to do it in a convention mode at 180 degree for hardly 2 or 3 minutes. That will be better, otherwise your burger buns will become little soft and soggy. Once your cheese is soft, we will add the caramelized onion over the top of the cheese, spread it nicely across. So the, as I told you, the caramelized onion is an important part. It means that nuttiness, that sweetness to the burger. So on the other side of the bun, we will add mayonnaise. We can also add the mango chili chutney, which is there on my YouTube channel. It will really taste very nice. So your burger is ready. I hope you all like this video. Kindly subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.